Good morning, SHS, and welcome to our second episode of Shen Center. First off, we will be starting with Jordan Miller and Tyler Hoyt giving us an update as the winter sports come to an end.
Today, we will be looking back on our winter sports seasons. Bowling, wrestling, and basketball all had winning records.
The boys' basketball record is currently 13-8 after a district win against Missouri Valley. Here is Austin and Brian with their updates on the season.
Our goals, and from my perspective, are we just need to come out in the end of the season winning. We need to play more as a team, and everybody needs to stay healthy, of course.
A strength for our team this year would probably be curls in the weight room. We've definitely been hitting the weight room hard all throughout the season, and that's mostly a lie. But we try to get in there as much as we can. So
the girls' basketball record is 15-8 with a strong win over the Atlantic Trojans in district competition. The Phillies have young, talented players who will all be returning next year, including Jessica and Logan.
The first half of our season has went well. We just need to be more consistent and talk more.
And we need to box out a lot better.
Our strengths are many of us players can shoot.
Yeah, when we have our flow going, we can shoot pretty well. We have a lot of good three-pointer shots. And we're pretty good at defense.
From here on out, we're just trying to get better and keep the positive attitudes and keep winning.
The Mustang wrestling team finished with 22 wins and 11 losses. Jake Johnson, J.D. Lewis, and Jake Stenzel all had wins at sectionals and advanced to districts. Seniors Brody and Logan will fill us in.
We've done pretty well. We've increased our winning percentage a lot. We are now, I believe, 21, 22, and 10 on the season. And it's just gone really well.
The team's doing a pretty good job. I'm happy with how we're doing. It's going by really fast. We've got a lot of guys that are stepping up, and we should have a good chance at getting some guys to go past sectionals.
It's a constant thought in my head. If it's not food, it's water. Water, I'd almost take over food.
I would agree with that. The thought of food really doesn't amount to the thought of liquid, because you can't get enough of it.
We're doing something that not a whole lot of other people are doing, and once you complete that complete wrestling, you feel very proud of yourself and self-accomplished.
Yeah, I'd have to agree with that. I feel like it makes you a better person, being able to have that self-control. It helps a lot of other things in life. When you're able to control your body like that, control your mind, and then get on the mat and still do better. He always sits like this with an iPad, and he'll like look down like this and like have the pen like touching his mouth like this. And then when he goes to yell at you, like yell like a move he wants you to do, he'll like cover his mouth like this, and you can't ever hear him. So he's like, "Crossface! Crossface!" Or he's like, Wizard! That's pretty much what he does.
I can't beat that.
SHS bowling continues to set new records. Both teams finished third in the Hawkeye 10, and the boys had their first appearance at state. Chase and Justine share team and personal highlights.
Alright, the first half of the season went by pretty well. We only had two losses so far to Lewis Central and Denison. And the Denison was close, but we lost it. It was a sad loss.
The season for us for the first half has gone well. We only had one loss against Red Oak, our toughest competition this year. Other than that, it's gone great.
The boys had better team cheers. One that we like to say is nuts and bolts, nuts and bolts. He got screwed. That's when you looks like it's going to be a strike and you don't throw a strike. Well, we just got a new one. It's no prob, chemo sob, you got robbed. And then we also have, if you leave a 5-pin, it's like the easiest spare out there. You literally have to throw the same ball you threw the first ball. And so we say, easy spare. And yeah, we just have a cool chance. The other meet, we were doing stuff with our feet. We were winning big. So it's just fun. We have fun. Probably more fun than you guys.
They definitely have better cheers.
You guys just
That's
go.
Because you come up with different things. You guys come up with like sayings.
Well, all you guys do is go.
Jesse, do you feel like they have better cheers, or they're just better at whining and doing negative cheers?
I think they're better at whining.
I'm done with this interview. I'm out.
This district champ! Yes!
Good job to all winter athletes. Track, golf, and tennis will be in full swing soon. We have awesome dedication from our athletes and fans. Keep up the good work, Mustangs and Phillies.
Guys, now it's time for Maddie's Top Trends.
Well, hello there, SHS. This is Madison Hagwood with your top trends. First off, we have new fashion options to kick off your new year. According to www.harpersbazaar.com, the new clothing options for 2016 would be, number one, Old English sleeves. Number two, in your face lace. Number three, Band-Aid. Number four, robe life. Number five, die for it. Yes, I know these are probably all high-end, expensive, weird, whatever, but it could give you inspiration for something you might like. Next, we have something from last year. Last year's word of the year, according to Oxford's dictionary, is the tears laughing emoji. No kidding, the word of the year for last year is an emoji. Now, isn't that a laugh? Last thing we have for the new year is nail and hair options, such as hot hippie and liquid chrome. For hair, there is a new trend going around that is just out of the pool look. Well, that's all for me, SHS. I'll see you next time on Shen Center.
Thank you, Madison. Now our last segment of an episode of Drinko with Alex, Caitlin, Jack Weber, and Nick Stanley.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to this week's session of Drinko.
What's Drinko?
What? You don't know what Drinko is? Well, I'll explain it to you. Drinko is a game where you're going to take the Plinko board and two chips. And what they're going to do is they're going to drop one chip down the Plinko board, and then they'll drop the other one. Whatever the two discs land on, they have to mix the drink and drink it. And the third and final round, what's going to happen is each boy will get one chip, and they will each drop it down at the same time. But whoever's disc gets their last has to drink whatever lands at the bottom. All right, and this week I have with me senior Jack Weber and sophomore Nick Stanley. Tell me, boys, how are you feeling about this?
Feeling good. I'm ready to do it.
Excellent. Austin Whitrock, you're a coward.
All right, let's get this show on the road. Nick, your go. As much as you can muster. Oh. You, sir, have an iron gut. Jack Weber, it's your turn.
No! You knew!
All right, gentlemen, it is time for the final round.
No! Oh, that's not part of that.
Yes, sir.
Oh, look at that. Oh, that's
nice and frothy. It's got great gross texture.
Gross.
And there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for joining us on this week's episode of Drinko. Have a nice day.
Oh!
Tyler O'Neill. That's a man jam.
That the Dominiques and the Jordans have.
And here is Vince Carter with his first shot.
Let's go home! Let's go home, ladies and gentlemen!
All right, Vince Carter with his first on the final round.
Wait, time out. Can I take a time?
Went across that night.
Oh, it's not
over. It's over! It's over, ladies and gentlemen!
This building just exploded.
By Jackson, but very nice.
Simp gets it.
Quick move by Hill, but Tumbo was a little finger wave to the crowd, leading shot blocker in the NBA, and the finish.
His ability to put the ball on the floor and get all the way to the basket.
What a victory! The jam! The big ticket punches one home.
Picks it up. Garnett's lurking from behind. Yeah, he's going to get it and dunk.
To be tricky, and it may cost the Nuggets a four-point swing.
You ever see a man that big slide?
Bryce falling away, won't go. O'Neal the rebound. Now the Magic with a final shot chance. O'Neal runs the floor, takes it all the way.
This game, Dennis Scott was starting. Bowie was coming off the bench as O'Neal follows and almost and does bring down the entire backcourt.
And as always, stay classy, Shenandoah.